Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Momodora 3 with me, Atantuo. We are in Artemisia's grave, and I actually looked it up in between episodes, as I said last episode, because it bothered me, and it turns out that both Edea and Artemisia are characters from Final Fantasy VIII. That is, if you played, if you played the German version of the game. I mean, Edea is the same in the English version as well, but apparently the character known as Artemisia, or Artemisia, is translated as Artemisia in the German version. So that's definitely where I heard that first. I mean, it's I've not played the game since it came out, basically. I played it when it was new as a kid, and or as a teenager, I guess, and never played it since, and never played it in English, actually, so that's why I wasn't even aware that she's not called the same thing in the English version. So, coincidence? Maybe? Maybe not. Again, since the main developer of this game is from Brazil, maybe he's familiar with the Portuguese translation of Final Fantasy VIII, if there is such a thing. I assume there is. And she might be called Artemisia in that version as well, so maybe that's a connection. Or maybe I'm just over-interpreting things. That's a possibility. Why did I jump through this platform first time? I do not know. Anyway. I doubt... Oh, wow, that's a bomb thrower. Please don't do that. Oh, okay. Maybe this is one of those places where I would profit from having the long-range special skill thing equipped. Oh, now I wonder if I could have made the jump, and maybe there's something over there. You know what? I'm actually going to suicide. Well, that's harder than expected, due to the item that increases my defense and iframes, but I'm not going to unequip that just for this one occasion. I'm only going to try to jump once. Maybe it's not even possible to make, but it strikes me as a likely place for a secret. Something that I would do if I was a game designer. What? Did I not save at that? I guess I must not have saved at that save point up there. Yeah, I was so occupied with talking about Final Fantasy VIII. Now I saved. And I'm going to... well, never mind. That was a long screen shake there. Wonder what's up with that. I am going to ignore most of these enemies. Well, not that one. Or that one. Okay. Let's try this again. It's probably not even possible, and if it is... What? Oh, did that bomb deal that much damage to me? What the heck? That's crazy. That is absolutely nuts. I did not pay attention to my health. That must be what happened. Jeez. Or, I don't know. I mean, I must have started with full health. So, I guess that's the only way I could have died that quickly. Ouch. Yeah, because the throne... Wow, did that just kill me instantly? What the heck? Could have sworn I got hit by that first bomb thrower earlier. Man, that's crazy. Why do they do these explosions kill me instantly? That doesn't seem right. I mean, if that's what it is, that's what it is. But yep, okay, well, confirmed. Sorry about making you suffer through my failures over and over. I mean, it's not like I'm enjoying it particularly. Okay, I managed to jump through this platform again. that's interesting to know. Come on, really? That's silly. That should not have happened. Okay, speedrun mode activate. Kind of semi speedrun mode activate. Okay. Speedrun mode? Maybe? Well, kind of. Speedrun as in ignore that one enemy. Why did that not hurt me? That was an explosion, wasn't it? Make the jump, yes, and there's nothing here. Great, awesome. What a missed opportunity. I mean, while it would have been really mean to make me replay this first area again for missing a single jump, it would also have been a pretty good secret. Don't know what exactly happened there. Oh man. That was really silly though. Okay. Ah, screen shakes are just happening sometimes. I only just noticed. So that was not related to me dropping down earlier. This is slightly tricky. If I manage to get hit there. Okay. Whoa! Backrock demon! Holy crap. Hidden boss. Oh my god. This is unexpected. And not very well hidden. I mean, that platform in between the spikes was pretty obvious, I think. Okay, how am I going to dodge these? Not at all, apparently. Is there any way to get closer to the guy so I don't have to rely on throwing these things? Ouch. I'm going to try and run in, since I'm gonna die anyway. Oh, I cannot actually... Huh. So I cannot run through him, he blocks my way, but I'll have to replay this whole beginning area once again. Isn't that great? So what I'm going to do, if I can... Again, why didn't that bomb kill me instantly? What the hell is wrong with that? I don't get how this works at all. Run through, or not. I guess the distance to the ceiling is too short for me to run under them without getting hit. That's fine. So I'm definitely going to try and find a save point before attempting that, what I assume is an optional boss first. I mean, it's pretty obvious, isn't it, that there's something. I mean, it's in between insta-death spikes, so that's a thing. Okay. Ah! Again! Nope. That killed me. Nah. That's a relatively tricky bit of platforming there, gotta say. I mean, it's to be expected that the game becomes more challenging the further you progress. That's completely expected and okay, of course. Doesn't mean that I'll be able to deal with it any better. Okay, let's do this. Let's take this one factor out of the equation. I should be able to make it easily enough. Like this, for example. And we have that bomb thrower that I'm deathly afraid of. No! Jumped a little too early. Ah, man. That's rough. Still not sure why sometimes those explosions kill me instantly and sometimes not. Maybe the times where I thought I got hit and didn't die, I did not actually get hit. Maybe I got hit by the thrown block instead. And still had iframes from that. That's a possibility. Let's do this first part again, at the very least. Okay, you start throwing your bombs. Okay, oh, that was better. Please, save point. No save point yet. Who are you? Are you friendly? You are. Hello. You look pathetically dull. Thanks. Perhaps you do not even have enough to buy the junk I offer. Oh, so you're the new shop owner. Huh. You have nothing to sell me. I guess I get several opportunities to buy certain items. Man, that's rough though. Does not look like I'll be able to return once I jump down here. Oh no. Okay, never mind, I will. And there is a save point. Okay, good. The game is not that evil. That's very, very good to know. Saved. Who are you? She doesn't seem to be breathing. Oh, wow. That's... Okay. Oh, what? That's not optional at all. Huh. Is that just a... shortcut? I'm going to enter through the other way first, just to... or again, I should say. Just to make sure it's actually the same thing, but of course, it's below, right below this chamber. That's really interesting. I should also do something like this. Get hit. Use my iframes to get down here. Huh. Okay, mash. He does not have a lot of health. And I should be able to kill him before he kills me. Yeah, definitely. Woo! Glad that's the case, because otherwise, I don't know... not sure what a better way there would have been to deal with this guy. Well, he's dead now. Guess I should save. Was most likely completely... most likely it didn't matter at all. That's what I'm trying to say, which way you enter this chamber. Guess it's just an alternate route to enter the boss fight from above, maybe for speedrun purposes. Circumvent that one room, although it... Oh. Okay. Not quite sure what happened there, except that I definitely got hit by that explosion this time, and it did not kill me. This time it did. That's great. Okay. Maybe I'll figure it out one of these days. Yeah. Not sure how to deal with that, except, well, I do have an idea. And that is actually equipping... Where is it? This thing. This is one of those situations where I just run into the spike pit for no reason. Maybe down. Much faster. Yeah, this might be one of those situations where I actually profit from having infinite range. Oh, and also piercing. And dealing way more damage. Okay. Bye-bye, guys. This is a... Without this item, it's a pretty terrible room. Hey, who are you? Paying your respects to the dead? It doesn't matter. Rarely I see someone visiting this grave. This is a location that connects the world of the living and the world of the dead. On the other side, you might find horrible things, and evil even worse than death. I advise you to step back. Do you now? And, who might you be? Ah, the way you dress is very reminiscent of the people from the village of Koho. Did I get that right? To be honest, it's been centuries since I've seen one of you. Back in the day, a girl dressed in white just like you purified this land from evil. I wonder what happened to her. Is that a reference to the very first game? Maybe, although that should not have been like centuries ago. Artemisia was my sister. She was a kind and protective figure. This grave was built to worship her, her heroic duties for my people. That is a very old and forgotten story, though. Is that so? Okay. Artemisia's sister. I cannot actually interact with this grave. Okay, well. In that case... I'm just gonna leave. Just like that. Also, I don't think I found a single secret in this whole area. This door is not locked. Yes? No boss fight, huh? Oh, no, wait. That was a boss fight. It just wasn't at the end of the... Oh, hell. Oh, hell no. That's unexpected. So, of course, there was a boss fight. Derp. It was just not at the end of the area. Apparently that was enough to confuse me and to confuse me into thinking there wasn't a boss at all. Anyway, I'm going to save here, lest I forget again, like last time. And I guess we're going to explore this game's version of Hell in the next episode. I hope you enjoyed so far. If you did, please hit like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you real soon. Till then. Have a wonderful time, and bye-bye.